Thanks everyone for joining me today for our seated dance aerobics workout. We're gonna get started with a nice dynamic warm up to get our bodies moving and grooving before we get into the workout. If you wanna follow along with me, go ahead. If you wanna do your own little warm up, that's totally fine as well. But I'm gonna start by just being seated in my chair. I'm gonna start with some ankle circles. So I'm just going to do my right foot first and then move to my left foot. Just coming up to the toes on my right foot and then moving my ankle in clockwise circles. Depending on like your flexibility, your ankle mobility, you can make these circles as big or as small as you like. We're just starting to loosen them up. After I've gone a couple rounds in one direction, I'm gonna go the opposite direction. Still working on my right foot, but now I'm going counterclockwise. And then from here, I'm going to switch feet, move to my left foot. Same thing, going to start my circles clockwise. My left ankle is a little bit tighter than my right ankle, so I'm just taking it a little bit slower. And then I'm going to switch, go the opposite direction. Awesome. Once you're feeling good with ankle circles, I'm going to plant my feet on the ground. I'm going to move to some wrist circles. So same thing, I'm gonna do both wrists at the same time here, just moving them. I'm actually going in opposite directions with my wrist circles at the same time, and then I'm gonna switch and then go the opposite direction, just loosening up our wrists. Once you're feeling good with rolling out your ankles and your wrists, I'm gonna move into some shoulder circles. So I'm gonna bring both my shoulders up at the same time towards my ears and then push them back behind me, pushing my chest out forward just slightly and then bringing the shoulders back around. Taking my time here with these shoulder rolls, really feeling that kind of like massage feeling as you're bringing your shoulders up and then back around. Gonna go the opposite direction here. I was going backwards. This time I'm gonna go forwards. Again, taking my time. Bringing my shoulders up to my ears. This time my chest caves in just a little bit. I feel my shoulder blades separate and then I go back around. Once you're feeling good with your shoulder circles, gonna let my shoulders go to neutral, shake out my hands, lower them down at my side. I'm gonna move into some high knees. So I'm gonna put my hands on my hips. You can put your hands on the arms of your chair if you have them. And I'm just gonna bring one knee up towards my chest at a time. Marching in place or high knees, whatever speed you want to go at, which feels good for you. Sometimes I like to start slow and then maybe gradually pick up my speed here. We'll go for about 10 more seconds with high knees. And 3, 2, 1. Awesome. I'm going to move into some windmill toe touches. Gonna move my feet a little bit farther than shoulder width apart, sitting forward in my chair, keeping my back straight. And then I'm gonna put my arms into a T position, extended at either side. And I'm gonna touch opposite hand down to opposite foot. If that doesn't feel good for you, you can touch opposite hand to opposite knee, still getting that core twist in. Going at your own speed here, we'll go about 10 more seconds with these windmill toe touches. Awesome. And 3, 2, 1. And let's finish it out here with some open the gate. Gonna start with my feet shoulder width apart. Gonna start with my right knee, bringing my right knee up towards my chest and then bringing it out to the right. So I'm opening up my groin, stretching that inside leg muscle, and then bringing my foot around back to the front. And I'm gonna do that on both legs alternating. Now I'm gonna bring my left knee up to my chest, bring that left knee out to the left, feeling that stretch in the inside of my leg, and then bringing my feet back together. Let's just alternate, open the gate a couple times on each leg at your own speed here. And then that will be it for our warm-up for the day. Last couple. Awesome, once you're feeling good with your open the gate, I am gonna get into talking about our sequences for the day. If you wanna keep warming up as I chat a little bit, that sounds great. Today we are doing seated dance aerobics. I have 3 different sequences of moves. Each sequence has 4 dance moves in it. I'm going to describe each move at the beginning, and then we're going to go through each sequence to a song. So sequence number one, we have four exercises. Each exercise we're going to do for about 8 counts of the music. Again, not going to be perfect, just whatever feels good for us. The goal today is just to keep our bodies moving and dance along to some music, get our heart rates going. And then we're going to just repeat that sequence over and over again for the whole song. So I'll call out the changes in the moves and you can follow along with me. And then we'll go into the next sequence when we go to the next song. So at the beginning of each sequence, I will go over all the moves. So if you have any questions, feel free to shout them out. But with that, let's get started by going over the moves for sequence number one. The first move in sequence number one, we have a march in place. So I'm going to start seated in my chair. I'm going to start sit a little bit forward so I have some room to move my legs and room to move my arms. So for this one, our lower body is just going to be doing a march in place. So one knee is coming up to our chest at a time. And then I'm going to add in an upper body movement. I'm going to swing my arms in opposition, kind of like I'm jogging in place or walking in place.
Oh, I see what you mean.
So as I bring up my left knee towards my chest, I'm going to swing my right arm forward. And then as my left leg comes down, I'm going to bring that left or my right arm back to the starting point. And then I'm going to switch sides, bring that right leg up, and then my left arm. So just kind of like you're walking in place, but also adding in those arm swings to add a full body movement to our march in place. Any questions with the first exercise? All right. And then the second exercise we have is a punch across. So this one, just an upper body movement here. You can sit back a little bit into your chair. And then I'm going to start with my right arm. I'm going to punch my right arm across my body towards the wall to my left. As I'm punching, my hips and my chest are turning just slightly. So I am feeling that twist in my spine and in my core. Then I'm coming back to center and then repeating the same thing on the left side, punching my left arm across my body to the right. And we're just going to alternate punching across. Key for this one is sitting up straight, bringing that belly button in towards your spine. So you really feel that core engagement as you're punching, as well as that arm engagement as well. Any questions with punch across? Awesome. And then the third exercise we have is an overhead wave. So this one, just like it sounds, we're going to bring both of our hands up towards the ceiling, fingertips to the sky, and we're just going to wave from left to right, kind of just moving your core and your hips side to side, keeping your feet planted on the ground. Any questions with overhead wave? All right. And then the last one, this is a kind of a new exercise that I just made up last week. So we'll see how it goes. This is called knee hops. So for this one, I'm going to sit back into my chair or lean back into my chair just a little bit. So I'm actually engaging my core. I'm going to use the handle of my chair to hold on, and I'm going to jump both feet together from the left to the right. So my knees are together, my feet are together, and I'm hopping from left to right with both of my feet at the same time. So I'm feeling that core engagement. I'm also feeling my quad and my hamstrings engaged as I'm hopping from left to right. If that doesn't feel good for you, you can do one leg at a time. So just start by hopping your right foot, one hop, left foot, one hop, and then just alternate. Or you can just sidestep by stepping one foot out to the right, one foot out to the left. Definitely different modifications that you can do for that one. But does anyone have any questions? All right, for all these moves, make it your own. Have fun with it. Again, the goal is to just move our bodies and dance along to the music. Add some flair and let's have some fun. So we're going to start at the beginning. First exercise is march in place. And our first song is Classic. Let me know if the volume is too loud, too quiet. But let's get started with March in Place. And punch across. And overhead wave. and knee hops. Hopping my feet together here from left to right. And march in place. Punch across. And overhead wave. And knee hops. I'ma pick you up in a Cadillac like a gentleman, bring it glamour back, keep it real to real in the way I feel. And march in place. And punch across. And overhead wave. And knee tap, knee hop, sorry. March in place. Punch across. And overhead wave. Knee hops. And march in place. And punch across to finish it out here. Let me try to pause my music. Nice job, everyone. Sequence number one is complete. Grab a little bit of water. Catch your breath a little bit. My music is on like fade, so I can't really, before the song ends, try to end it before the next one starts. But great job. Sequence number two, four new exercises here. The first exercise for sequence number two is a lateral arm raise, or lateral arm pumps is what I'm gonna call it. So I'm gonna start just sitting up tall in my chair. I'm gonna move my arms into T position. So elbows are straight, extended out to both sides. For this movement, I'm just gonna do small pumps up and down with my arms, keeping my arms in that T position, keeping my hands and just going a little bit up or down from my shoulders, but keeping it mostly level, just focusing on feeling that shoulder burn with the lateral raise. Take breaks if you need, but does anyone have any questions with lateral raise? Next exercise we have is called point and clap. So I'm gonna start with my right hand. I'm gonna start by pointing my right hand to the wall to my right. After I point my right hand, bringing my hands together in front of my chest and giving it a nice clap. And then I'm gonna go the opposite side. So now I'm pointing my left hand to the wall to my left, bringing my hands together at the center to clap, and just alternating left and right, point and clap. Any questions with that one? Awesome. The third exercise is a sidestep. So sitting up a little bit further in my chair for this one, starting with my feet shoulder width apart, I'm just stepping my right foot one step out to the right, bringing it back in, and then stepping my left foot one step out to the left, bringing it back in. For this one, you can control how far you want to step your leg. If you want to extend all the way, really feel that reach and that hamstring stretch, and then bring it back in. Or if you want to keep your steps smaller and just focus on speed, totally fine as well. Any questions with sidestep? Awesome. And the final one we have is a reach up and down. I'm going to start sitting tall in my chair, reaching both hands up towards the ceiling, extending my elbow straight from this position, reaching all the way down, trying to touch the ground, touch your feet, touch your knees. Just a reach up and down, engaging our core. Any questions with any of those movements? All right, sequence number two, let's get it. Starting at the top with lateral raise. Second song. Go ahead. And point and clap. Try to get your own flair into it. Try to go on the beat. And sidestep. And reach up and down. And lateral raise. Point and clap. Sidestep. Reach up and down. And lateral raise. And point and clap. Sidestep. Reach up and down. Lateral raise. And point and clap. Sidestep. And reach up and down. Lateral raise. Point and clap. And sidestep to finish it out. Woo! Nice job, everyone. Sequence number two is done. I'm gonna grab a little water here. Awesome. Moving to sequence number three, our last new sequence before we start back at the beginning. Four new exercises. The first little dance move that I have here is a core shimmy. I also made this one up, so it might be new. I'm gonna start by sitting tall in my seat, focusing on moving our core here and moving kind of our shoulders. So I'm gonna start by bringing my right shoulder down towards the center of my body. And I'm gonna go like one count with my right shoulder down and then bring my left shoulder in towards my body to bring that down towards the center. So starting right shoulder down, left shoulder down, and then I'm gonna go backwards, bring my left shoulder back, right shoulder back. So just a core shimmy, shimmying forward, shimmying backwards, focus on engaging your core as you're moving forward and backwards. Add in your own spice with this one. It's supposed to be a little bit fun to move forward and then shimmy backwards, but staying, keeping your hips facing forward, engaging that core. Does anyone have any questions with a core shimmy?
So you're having your elbows next to your body and you're bringing your shoulders down and up. Is that what you're doing?
Yeah, you can have your hands on your hips. You can have your hands on your thighs, just focusing on moving your chest and your hips forward and then bringing it backwards. I'm just adding in a little bit of a shimmy flare by bringing my shoulders down first. Yeah.
Oh, okay. Gotcha. Thank you.
So it's kind of like you're moving your moving your top part of your body like side to side.
Yeah, I'm not totally.
Okay.
Yeah.
But you're just adding a shoulder thing. I'm trying to get it so I won't do it wrong.
No, you're doing it great. Whatever feels good is totally what works for you. I'm just moving my shoulders forward and backwards as I'm moving my hips forward and backwards. So just adding in a little bit of a shake, a little bit of a shimmy as I'm going forward with my hips and backwards with my hips.
Okay.
Yeah. Awesome. And then the second exercise we have are heel taps. So starting with my feet shoulder width apart, stepping my right foot one step forward, tapping my heel on the ground, bringing that right foot back, then my left foot, tapping my left heel one step forward, and then bringing my foot back. So just alternating heel taps. Any questions with that one? Awesome. Third exercise we have are shoulder shrugs. So this time I'm starting with my hands down at my side, fingertips pointed towards the ground. I'm going to shrug both of my shoulders at the same time. So bringing my shoulders up to my ears and then lowering them back down. Again, this one going at your own speed. If it feels better for you to do one shoulder at a time, that's an option as well. But again, working those shoulders, bringing them up and down to your ears. Any questions with shoulder shrugs? Then the last exercise we have is a high knee core twist. Starting sitting up tall, I'm going to bring my hands behind my head, not grabbing onto them tight, but just so my elbows get into that bent position. And then from here, I'm going to bring opposite elbow to opposite knee. So my right elbow is going to come to my left knee. I'm going to bring my left knee up towards my chest, try to touch knee to elbow, and then I'm going to alternate lowering that down and then going on the left side, bringing my left knee to my right elbow. Modification here, you can bring your hands down to your side. You don't have to have them at the back of your head, just getting your body as close as you can to feel that core crunch, or you can just take opposite hand and tap the top of your opposite knee. Any questions with any of our movements? All right, sequence number three. We are starting at the top with our core shimmy. Starting in 3, 2, 1. Go ahead. And heel taps. Shoulder shrug. And high knee core twist. And core shimmy. And heel tap. Shoulder shrug. High knee core twist. And And back to core shimmy. And heel tap. And shoulder shrug. High knee core twist. And back to core shimmy. Heel tap. Shoulder shrugs. And high knee core twist. And back to core shimmy. And heel taps to finish. Woo! Nice work, everyone. All three sequences complete. Grab some water. Awesome job. We're back to the beginning with sequence number one. Our moves for sequence number one, we have march in place, punch across, overhead wave, and knee hops. Does anyone have any questions with any of those movements? All right, let's do it. Starting at the top. Sequence number one, we have march in place in 3, 2, 1. Go ahead, march in place. Lately I found myself thinking, been dreaming about and punch across. And up in my head, I'm your boyfriend. But that's one thing you've already got. And overhead wave. He drives to school every morning, while I walk alone in the rain. He'd kill me without anyone. And knee hops. If he took a look in my brain, would he say he's in that low VE? Well, if it was me, then I would. And back to march in place. Punch across. And overhead wave. Back in my head, we were kissing. I thought things were going all right. With a sign on my back saying, kick me. And knee hops. And back to march in place. And punch across. Overhead wave. And knee hops. And and march in place. And punch across. And overhead wave. Would he hold you when you're feeling low? Baby, you should know that I would. Knee hops. And march in place. And punch across. And finish it out. Woo! I need to fix my playlist so it doesn't hop right to the next song. But nice job. Woo! I'm definitely feeling it from those knee hops. Grab some water. Catch your breath. Awesome. On to sequence number two. Moves for sequence number two. We have lateral raise, point and clap, sidestep, and reach up and down. Any questions with any of those movements?
That reach up and down, you're just reaching up and then down to the floor. Is that right? I kind of forgot.
Yep. I'm just extending my arms, fingertips to ceiling, and then reaching down, try to touch the ground or your feet.
Okay. Gotcha. Thank you.
Yeah. Sure. All right, let's do it. Starting at the top with lateral raise. In 3, 2, 1. Go ahead. Lateral raise. And point and clap. Been at this and I've messed around. I'm having fun. Don't put me down. I'll never let you sweep me off my feet. And sidestep. I won't let you in again. The messages I've tried to send. My information's just not going in. I'm burning bridges shore to shore. I break away from something more. I'm not turned on to love. And reach up and down. Back to lateral raise. And point and clap. Sidestep. Reach up and down. Tick, 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 tick on the watch. Life's too short for me to stop. Oh, baby, your time is running out. And back to lateral raise. Tell me now, I'm much too proud. All you do is fill me up with doubt. This time, baby, I'll be believe. And point and clap. And sidestep. And reach up and down. And lateral raise. And point and clap. This time, baby, I'll be sidestep. And reach up and down. And finish it out. Woo! Nice job, everyone. Grab some water. We are back to sequence number three. Now we are cruising through. Sequence number three, our movements, we have our core shimmy, heel taps, shoulder shrugs, and high knee core twist. Does anyone have any questions about any of those moves? All right, we are gonna start at the top with core shimmy in 3, 2, 1. Go ahead, core shimmy. And heel taps. In the closet, that's my stuff. Yes, if I bought it, nigga, please don't touch. Don't try and keep talking and mess, that's fine. But could you walk and talk at the same time, man? It's my name, it's a neck bag. And shoulder shrugs. They call you a cab, sending in the front door. How I'm such a fool, talking about how I'll never ever find a man like you. And tiny core twist. And back to core shimmy. And heel taps. And shoulder shrugs. Tiny core twist. And core shimmy. And heel taps. And shoulder shrugs. And high knee core twist. And back to core shimmy. And heel tap. And shoulder shrugs. And high knee core twist. And core shimmy. And heel tap. To finish. Woo. Nice job, everyone. We are back to the beginning. Gonna grab a little water. Awesome. We are back to sequence number one. We have about 15 minutes left, so we could probably get through a couple more songs. Sequence number one, we have March in Place, Punch Across, Overhead Wave, and Knee Hops. Any questions with any of those? All right, let's do it. Starting at the top with March in Place, we are following the Beyonce theme, two Beyonce songs in a row. Here we go. Starting in 3, 2, 1, March in Place. And Punch Across. And Overhead Wave. And Knee Hops. Back to March in Place. And Punch Across. And Overhead Wave. And Knee Hops. And March in Place. And Punch Across. Overhead Wave. And Knee Hops. And March in Place. And Punch Across. And Overhead Wave. And Knee Hops. Back to March in Place. And Punch Across. Overhead Wave. And Knee Hops. To March in Place. And Punch Across. And Overhead Wave. And Knee Hops. Baby, and march in place to finish it out. Nice job. We are crushing it, grabbing a little water here. Sequence number two. We got about 10 minutes left, so I think we can get maybe one more song. Sequence number two, we have lateral raise, point and clap, sidestep, and then reach up and down. Does anyone have any questions? All right, this probably will be our last song. I'll pick a longer one so we can finish it out strong here. And we're going to start at the top with lateral raise in 3, 2, 1. Go ahead. And point and clap. And sidestep. And reach up and down. And lateral raise. And point and clap. And sidestep. And reach up and down. And lateral raise. And sidestep. And reach up and down. And lateral raise. And point and clap. And sidestep. And reach up and down. And back to the top, lateral raise to finish it out. Woo. Nice work, everyone. Awesome job. We have five 5-ish minutes left in our workout today. Let's grab some water, and then we'll move into a nice cool down, get some stretching in. Awesome job today, everyone. We are going to get into a cool down. I'm going to start by just extending both of my legs forward in my chair. I'm going to sit back a little bit. Just extend those legs out. Hold it there for a few moments. And then I'm going to reach both my hands up towards the ceiling, taking in a really big inhale breath as I'm reaching, extending both my arms and my legs. And then exhale, I'm going to hinge at my waist. Try to touch my hands down to my toes, to your knees. Just stretching out our hamstrings a little bit. Stretching out those legs. Going to hold on here for a few seconds. And then when you're ready, I'm going to go through that sequence again. So I'm going to slowly sit back up, reach both my arms back to the ceiling, taking in a really deep breath. And then on your exhale, hands come down towards your toes. I'm going to do that 3 times. So one more. On that last exhale, reaching for my toes, going to see if I can get my chest close to my legs, really stretch out those hamstrings. And then when you're feeling good, I'm just going to slowly sit back up. I'm going to bring my feet flat onto the floor, and I'm going to do a figure four stretch here. So I'm going to take my right foot, and I'm going to place it over the top of my left knee so that my right knee is bent facing the wall to my right, and the bottom of my right foot is pointed towards the left, stretching out my right hip flexor, my right leg groin. If it doesn't feel good for you to get that leg all the way up on top of your knee, extend that left leg straight, and then just cross your right leg on your left leg wherever it feels good. You can still get that figure four just with a little less impact or pressure. When that's feeling good, I'm going to switch. I'm going to lower that right foot to the ground, and then I'm going to bring my left leg on top of my right knee this time. This leg is a little bit tighter for me, so I am going to extend that right leg straight, still getting that stretch in my left hip, my left groin. Awesome. When that's feeling good, I'm going to uncross both my legs, let them come back down to the ground. I'm going to stretch out my arms here and my shoulders. So I'm going to start by taking my right arm, bringing my right arm across my chest. Fingertips are going to point to the wall to my left. And then with my left hand, just grabbing at my right elbow and gently pulling in towards my body. Stretching out my right shoulder a little bit here. Once that feels good, I'm going to switch. Let my arms shake out a little bit. Now I'm going to bring my left arm across my chest. Fingertips point to the right. And with my right hand, pulling in that elbow close to my body. And again, hold it here for a few seconds. When that's feeling good, I'm going to release, shake out both my arms, let them fall down at my side. And then let's finish here with a little bit of a neck stretch sequence. I'm going to sit up nice and tall in my chair, have my hands down at my side so my shoulders are neutral. I'm going to bring my left ear down towards my left shoulder. So I'm feeling that stretch throughout the right side of my neck. Just going to hold it here for a few moments. Taking some deep breaths as you're feeling that stretch. When that is feeling good, I'm going to bring my head back to neutral. And I'm going to do the same thing now on the right side. Bringing my right ear down towards my right shoulder. Check to see if your shoulders are relaxed and neutral. So you're really feeling the most stretch throughout that left side of your neck. When that's feeling good, bringing my head back to neutral, This time I'm going to point my nose up towards the ceiling. So tilting my head back, feeling that stretch in the front of my neck, down even into my chest a little bit. Taking some deep breaths. And then when you're ready, bringing your head back to neutral. We'll finish here with bringing our chin to our chest, pointing our nose to the floor. This time we're feeling that stretch now throughout the back of our neck into our shoulder blades. And once you are feeling good, slowly bringing your head back to neutral. Thank you all for joining me today for our seated dance aerobics. I hope you enjoyed it. And we will see you all next week. Thanks, everyone.
Thank you, Ashley. See y'all next week.